Hello and welcome to yet another episode of the Carrot Cast. Today a new event showed up which is called the Treasure Outlaws. So as you see, we are right now playing the Treasure Outlaws event. So I just want to show you how it is being played and what can you do to take the maximum advantage of the situation. So the event is straightforward. The event takes place on its own at 2 UTC, 8 UTC and 14 UTC. You do not have to trigger it. It happens on its own at the different holy sites which are present. Second important thing is this is not an alliance level event. It is an event which takes place for the entire kingdom at a time, which is really good news because we don't have kingdom level event except the KVK. So this is decent from that terms. Not so great thing about it is that you have to set alarm and get up and say that do you want to play this event at this specific time. For me, I missed the two opportunities. At 2 UTC it was too early for me. I saw the event, my marches started to walk, but I could not actually reach on time. I should have basically teleported. That would have been a better option. 8 UTC I was out, so 14 UTC I am now playing this event. Other thing to remember is the event does not start at 14 UTC. When it says 14 UTC, what happens is at 14 UTC a marker will appear at different holy sites which start showing that you need to start preparing, and in 10 minutes the Treasure Outlaws will appear. So as you see here, the Treasure Outlaws has disappeared from my screen because that is one of the techniques that it uses. Other thing you see are different chests which are being dropped and people are picking those chests. So you should pick up those chests. They are not so great. I am using a second march to pick up those chests. One more key thing that you need to remember is if you have a war frenzy on, you might be able to hit other players by mistake. As you see, currently I did not have a war frenzy on and I dragged and I was about to hit a player, but since the warning came, the disaster got avoided. But the whole idea is you gather together and the Treasure Outlaws appear and you keep hitting them. As you keep hitting them, the level of the chest keeps on going higher and higher, and the amount of gold that you accumulate also keeps on getting higher and higher. So as you see, right, I'm gaining the gold regularly whenever we are hitting. This Treasure Outlaw will keep on casting different kind of skills. Few of the skills, as you see here, is one of the skills where it disappears for some time. Luckily for us, it just appeared right here. The other kind of skill is where, look at this red circles that it is casting the spell on, and this is the shackles, so it can actually hold you there for some time. The next skill that it does is a stun skill. The stun skill is also pretty straightforward. It just stuns you and you can't do anything. You just have to sit idle in that location. Just now, as you see the spirals on the head which are showing up. One thing you have to remember is after you are stunned, you have to retarget the Treasure Outlaw. Otherwise, you are not going to actually hit it. Right now, as you see, right, the thing is, it has disappeared. Okay, it appeared again. So again, we can start hitting. One thing I really suggest for kingdoms to do is do not come at one holy site, because it is the accumulation of all the damage that you do to the Treasure Outlaws that actually count for you. So each alliance should actually concentrate on one specific holy site. So few can come to the Lost Temple, or at least one or two can come to the Lost Temple. Other can be at different shrines, etc., so that it's easier to manage and not hit others by mistake. And keep playing. This is a straightforward event. You keep hitting, you get some gold, and at the end hopefully we will get some decent rewards. So escape countdown is there, so it means that this is the amount of time that you have for you to keep hitting the members. Now if you see here, right, that outlaw has disappeared for some time and we are trying to figure out where exactly it is going to appear. So again, it appeared there only. So it just appears, disappears, changes direction and keep on casting your skills, and not a big deal. You get your best DPS march and keep hitting, because that is how you are going to get the maximum out of this event, because the more damage you cause, the higher level of chest will be there. And I actually do not know if we get higher level of chest, what's the advantage you are going to get. Here in this case, if you see, I got some decent awards, 317 minutes of speed ups, not much, some material, some experience and so on and so on. So not much, okay. Oh, there are some lucky leprechauns, they get gold heads, and then there are some misfortunates of it. So this is not so great. Let's see what actually happens. Here, this is the ROK anniversary event that has showed up. Different events are there. Treasure Outlaws, what we just played. Ode to Valor is an album. I do not think who want to listen to ROK albums, but it's available on Spotify. Not for me. Then we have Metropolitan Fair, which is all about designing. So people who are into designing of their city layouts can do that and post the pictures and you'll get some rewards. Not so great. And then there's an ROK yearbook. Okay, so I can see my ROK yearbook, and this is my third yearbook, so it should be interesting. All right, the success of your civilization has come from your hands. Good. The Arabia civilization from which you have never wavered since. So this is actually wrong. I was Germany to start my game, and then after in the first KVK I actually changed to Arabia. You have wage war for 360 days. Okay, that might be my KVK days. Okay. Due diligence, embarking from Kingdom of Palmas. You have traversed two equally kingdom things. So yeah, so I was from 1347, we went to 1334, and now we are in 1445. Stronger barbarian seek to challenge you and passes in holy sites. Okay, this is 2,097,000. Okay, Medal of Conquerors. Not very interesting. 1754 Holy Garden sites. So I think that was my year one when I was trying to gain different advantages. 23 different city buildings and 12 unique civilizations. Alright, I am VIP 14. And okay, this is the number of gems I have safely tucked away. You have gathered resources this many times and accumulated 5 billion resources in total, which is actually not correct, because my resource gathering tells me that I have gathered 14 billion resources. It might be just talking about this year. That might be the case. All right. You enjoyed the company of Phoenix Rebellion members. Yes, Phoenix Rebellion is our alliance. I have been part of this alliance since the beginning. In your tents, cavalry being your favorite, that is correct. Arabia is my civilization, so as I talk about it, yeah, I am trying to be a cavalry player. Okay, greatest strategist. You have turned the tides in 27 Ark of Osiris battles, contributing much to 3 victories, so pretty bad record for us here. Tried 27 times, won only 3 times. Kingdom of Saroli, okay, not my best of the things that I want to do. 212 times, so pretty good actually, things that I never knew what I had done or the total numbers. Throughout many brutal conflict, Attila has been your most capable commander. So that is true, because Attila gives you the maximum amount of kills, right? So I think that is what my current situation is. Fearless scholar, okay, decent. I like to call myself as great strategist. So this is what it is. All right, so I want to talk about two more things that are there. The first thing is the event that we talked about now. So I played it one more time and the rewards were as bad as before. But what I got a mail, or most of you actually got a mail, was that event announcement, and there were some bugs and people complained, and I got 3 legendary heads. So I think this is more than what I would have got even if I played all the 9 times. So this is good. And the best part about this update is the celebratory spoils. So as you see here, this is the first time for logging for 7 days, Blaze is giving 10 gold heads. Extremely good, my kind of an event. You don't have to do anything, just come log in and play. So this is fabulous. We will be upgrading our Tamar of Georgia, and I'm not very impressed with the commander, but as you saw that recently I asked for a new gathering legendary commander. They gave a new epic commander. I'm happy with it. What I like the most is the wood gathering speed. Even though wood as a resource I always have in plenty because I'm a cav player and I'm always running out of food, but no worries, like you gather more, you can share with your friends and so on and so on. So I'm actually be using this. Expertise is a little fine, not very interesting. Nearby ally with the fewest units remaining gain 20% increased defense and heal a portion of lightly injured troops per second. Not the best, but if you are in a bad situation, you can heal a rally or bring the commander if you don't have much. But still, I would go with Joan of Arc, Constantine, and Mulan. That's the pick that I would suggest for most of the people. And with this, I just wanted to talk one more thing. Last video we made, we were in the KDK, but you see now we have KDK notification on in just a matter of 7 to 8 days. We moved away from our kingdom, and even though it was in a KDK because the king was really bad in the previous kingdom, we were the equal alliance and they will not share the lost temple, and lots of challenges we faced and lot of favoritism amongst the players. So we decided to move to a new kingdom, 1445. Now we call ourselves Shadow Fighters. I am a Shadow Karate. That's the new name, new beginning for me here in this new place. As a complete alliance of 5 billion members, we moved everybody. So this is a group that we have together with us for over 2 years now, actually over 3 years now. So good for us to be the new kingdom, which is a B kingdom, and we will be soon getting into the fight because the KVK notification popped up today only. So with this, thank you very much for watching. I took a little bit of a break from the game. Now I'll be making content regularly. Thank you.